Hey guys, Majik here. Decided to do a little bit of a tutorial series for sort of online memory defrag. Now, obviously I'm not the world's best expert in this game or anything like that, but I started recently enough that I kind of still remember the things that I was confused about, what I needed cleared up. So hopefully this helps some people because I know there's a number of new players due to the OS banner and things like that. So in this video, I'm only going to cover a couple of things, but I think that it's good to lay the groundwork for things that people are interested in. So I'm going to talk about scouting, both characters and weapons. And then I'm also going to talk about elemental properties for both of those. So let's get right into it. So in this game, the gacha system is called scouting instead of like summoning or whatever. And what's cool about this game is that they actually give you the rates here. Now for the guaranteed banner, it says, for the 4-star guaranteed, it can basically pull any character for you, but in this banner particularly, any 4-star that you're going to get is going to be a banner unit. So, and they tell you what the rates are for those. The overall percentage of pulling a 4-star is going to be 4%. So, that's already better than, say, Brave Exvius, which is basically a 1% chance per pull. And out of that 4%, it's distributed evenly 0.8% per character. And again, all of the 4-stars that you get from this particular banner are going to be the featured units. And then the rest of the percentages are, divided up between 3-star and 2-star characters. So that's kind of cool that, they show you all that stuff. Now, there's a lot made about Argo's face. Argo is the person that you see when you scout. And I actually considered, going on my phone and trying to get the pictures of the different faces and, do it that way. But obviously that's pretty expensive. So what I did was I just stole pictures of the faces from various YouTube videos, and you're not going to be able to know which ones I stole it from. A couple of them are actually from mine, so I don't feel bad about it. But let me show you the faces right now. So let's say you're doing an 11 pull, right? The 11 pull, the face is going to correspond to the best pull out of the 11. So if you end up seeing this face, this is the 2-star smile. If you end up seeing this smile, that means that you're guaranteed your best pull from that banner, from the 11 pull, is going to be a guaranteed 2-star and up, which is really bad. So if you see this face, it doesn't mean that you can't get a 3-star or a 4-star, but what it means is that it's a guaranteed 2-star and up. So it'd be like getting a blue crystal in Brave Exvius. It's possible that it could crack into a yellow, it's possible that it could even crack into a rainbow. But what you can expect is a 2-star character. This obviously corresponds to single pulls as well. Now, if you end up seeing this face instead, it's like a cheesier, happier smile. This means that it's a 3-star guaranteed and up. Again, it can be a 4-star, but you're likely to expect a 3-star as the best unit off that pull. Now, if you see this smile, this kind of like mischievous grin kind of thing, this is the 4-star guaranteed smile. If you see this one, then at least one of your pulls from the 11, at least one of the units from the 11 pull is going to be a 4-star. Could be more, could be just one, but you're guaranteed at least one. Now the caveat to this, of course, is that any one of these faces has the chance to be a 4-star, again, if you kind of get that unexpected upgrade. Also, if any one of these faces has a sparkle around the head, like the face is the same, but there's sparkles around the head, the sparkles also guarantee a 4-star. So yeah, that's basically all there is to Argo's faces. This face is like pulling a blue crystal. This face is like pulling a yellow crystal, and this face is like pulling a rainbow crystal. It is possible to get a 4-star from any one of these faces, and especially if you see the sparkles, it's guaranteed. But that's pretty much it in a nutshell. Okay, so that's for character summons or scouts. Now, with weapon scouts, I'm not going to show pictures or anything like that because it's really easy to explain. One more thing, sorry. If you do an 11 pull on the characters, the best rarity character is always going to show up first. So if you get a 4-star as your first one, and then the second one is a 3-star, you can pretty much know at that point that everything past that point is going to be a 3-star or lower. So it's going to go 4-star, 3-star, 3-star, 2-star, 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 and so forth. So that's another thing. Okay, now with the weapon pulls. Again, each different type of chest has that chance of upgrading to a 4-star. It just depends on luck. You'll see, like, you know, the regular crystal, I think it's a blue crystal, come out, and then it has a chance to upgrade to a yellow, and then that yellow diamond has a chance to upgrade to like this pink rainbowish diamond, which would be the 4-star. But as far as expectations go, the wooden chests are the guaranteed 2-star weapon. The blue chest, like a nice looking blue chest, is a 3-star and up. And then the red chest, like a golden red chest, that's the guaranteed 4-star. Again, all of them have a chance for a 4-star, but the rough order is wood is 2, blue is 3, and red is 4. And again, they give you rates here as well. 4-star overall, and then here's how it's distributed. Again, it's only the banner weapons that are going to be 4-stars on this one. All 4-star weapons are OS weapons. It's not necessarily always like that, I guess. Okay, so that's all there is to the summoning system as far as, you know, what to expect and everything. The only other thing I'm going to discuss in this video is elements. So this can be a little confusing to new players. I know I was a little bit confused with it. Oops, wrong string. The only purpose of the different elements to the weapons and armors and accessories, like the gear basically, is whether or not it's going to give bonuses to your characters. The character's element, Lisbeth here is a non-elemental, it's like this gray color. Mayuki is a dark elemental, which is this purple color. Asuna is this light blue, which is water. Let me see if I have any other elements. These are all non-elemental. Okay, in this account, I don't really have a whole lot. This free Asuna here is earth element, which is orange. Green is wind. Yellow is holy or light. Red is fire. And then I think that's all of it. Yeah, so basically, if you're fighting, let's say, a fire dragon of some sort, that fire dragon is going to be weak to water. But what that means is that it's going to take extra damage from a water character. It's not going to take necessarily extra damage from a water weapon. So while, okay, I don't have any on this character, but she does have water armor and water accessories, so she's going to get bonus stats from this. But if you were to put, let's say, an ice sword on like a non-elemental character, that ice sword is not going to do any bonus damage to that fire dragon. A water element character will do extra damage. So that's how it works as far as weaknesses go. But if you put the correct element onto the character, that person does get bonus stats. So there's not a whole lot of examples I can use on this account, but let's use Yuna as an example. So she's a non-elemental. I have 2 swords here. I mean, they're not upgraded because it's not worth it at this point for me. But they both have the same stats, 305 attack. This is a non-elemental sword with 305. This is a fire sword, again with 305. But if I put the non-elemental sword on her, she's going to get higher attack because she's getting a bonus from that element matching her. So this is 1959 with the non-elemental sword. If she were to switch out to this fire sword, it goes down to 1898, even though the attack on the weapon is exactly the same. So that's pretty much the only reason why elemental attributes matter on gear. It's for the bonuses that they give to the characters. So that was a long-winded explanation, I apologize for that, but hope that makes some sense. And I think if I don't get blasted too hard for this video or anything like that, I think the next one that I'm going to cover is basically some basic fighting tips and, you know, the moves and things like that. So hope this was helpful for some of you guys and cleared up some confusion. And hope you enjoy this game like I do. Doesn't mean that I'm forgetting about Brave Exvius or anything like that. And if there's interesting stuff coming up, I'll definitely make videos. But I just wanted to kind of get people started on the right foot, because I know there's a lot of new players. And it's a pretty new game as well. So catch you guys next time.